This is Neil McNeil, and thanks for watching this Fox 8 News Web Extra featuring more of my recent Newsmaker interview with North Carolina State Representative Dale Folwell of Forsyth County. Over the next few minutes, he and I will discuss his support of the Defense of Marriage Act.
When I applied for this job 6 years ago, when I filled out what I told the voters I would do, I told them that I was in favor of a constitutional amendment that defined marriage between one man and one woman. This was already the law. It's been the law since 1996. As a matter of fact, the governor voted on it twice, and others have, who now are against it, supported it.
So why do you need a constitutional amendment?
The reason is to bring certainty and finality to this issue, because every 2 years people run about on the fact that they want, they're in favor of marriage between a man and a woman. They actually co-sponsor bills, they primary sponsor bills, they actually sign affidavits saying they're for this, but when they get to Raleigh, they don't do anything about it. The other thing it does is it brings predictability to this whole issue. We don't realize that this whole issue of marriage has been around since the mid-1600s in North Carolina. The definition of marriage has been in this state before North Carolina was even a state. And we don't realize how much marriage between one man and one woman is built into our tax laws, built into our real estate laws, built into our health care laws, built into so many things that we do in North Carolina. So if the state is going to sanction it, and it has been sanctioning it since the mid-1600s, it needs to protect it. So if we have that law on the books, and people are depending on that law, and you have an activist judge who says, based on some lawsuit, that we don't think that law is a good law, and I'm going to overturn that law. And as a matter of fact, anybody who's receiving same-sex benefits in private industry, it's going to be all or none. Then all of a sudden, private industry is having to react to what some activist judge says. The way that it should be is that private industry should have the flexibility and the choice to design their benefit packages any way they choose, without legislature being involved and without any activist judge being involved. It's very important to me to bring certainty to issues like this as we go forward. Anybody who's in favor of this or against this, who has the ability to launch, you know, massive media campaigns, they could all stand down. There's nothing that's requiring anybody to run an ad or to call anyone any name at all, period. People can just stand down on this issue, let the people look at the ballot, and let them decide on how they feel about it. It's very simple.